Hi everyone, I'm using Mystical Moments for our reading today. I'll choose three cards, take some from the base of the pack, and I'll also choose one from the gods, goddesses and angels as well for some extra guidance. And I'll choose one from Anna Stark's Sacred Light as well. So I'm setting the intention for a reading for the highest and greatest good for the collective or anyone who views this video. There we are, the King of Cups, the Moon, and the Ten of Swords. And at the base of the pack, we have the Three of Pentacles, the Page of Cups, the King of Wands, and the Four of Wands. So we have the King of Cups, and the King of Cups is very emotionally mature. And we're on this beautiful day today of the autumn equinox. The autumn equinox in the Northern Hemisphere and the spring equinox in the southern hemispheres. So today's a day of balance, equal 12 hours day, 12 hours night. And the King of Cups reminds us to stay in that equilibrium, to really calm ourselves today. We're moving through this portal on this equinox. It's the harvest, so we are reaping our rewards. We are harvesting everything that we have learnt, the wisdom. The King of Cups is very mature, very connected, very sensitive, but empathetic. And it's very psychic and spiritual. So we've got these wonderful energies now flowing, opening up our spirituality. This light that is coming through today and is entering Mother Earth. Mother Earth's energy body is opening, and she is absorbing this beautiful light from the cosmos that is bringing through sacred wisdom. The energy, these light codes that are coming through, are also entering our energy body as well, activating latent DNA within us that holds latent divine wisdom, wisdom from our ancestors. So there's a powerful activation as we're held in this equilibrium today. Holding on there, he is surveying that consciousness. Water to me is always the ocean of consciousness, and he's holding his ship there. Surveying is the landscape, the ocean, of where to place that ship down. So he's looking, staying in that beautiful place of peace, using his intuition to guide him. And today we have the Moon in Capricorn. And Capricorn is it's very earthy. So helping us to anchor these divine wisdom that is coming through, these light codes that are coming through in these light comes come through in particles of light, and in each particle holds immense wisdom, and we're absorbing it. So the Moon in Capricorn, the Moon is our feelings, and Capricorn is grounding, so it's helping us to ground and to anchor this divine wisdom and to use it in a practical way, being able to tap into our feelings, but then in a way that we can understand. Then we have the moon. Again, the moon is in its waxing, it's growing now, which is enhancing the energy of this equinox. The equinox is the sun in Libra, and the opposing sign to Libra is Aries, and we have Libra in the south nodes, Aries in the north nodes. So the south nodes is where we're moving from. The north node is the head of the dragon, where we're going, where we're heading, and the south node is the tail of the dragon, and where we're letting things go. Aries is at the north node, and Aries is the I am. And Chiron, the wounded healer, the sacred healer, is in Aries at this time, helping us to heal the wound of the I am, so that we can move through our relationships with clarity and with love and with harmony. And this is all around our relationships, this equinox, because the north node, Aries, the south node in Libra, is activating during this eclipse. Pluto is opposing the nodes, the moon's nodes. So asking us to really go deep into our innermost feelings. Pluto is the planet of transformation, helps us to transform those old and rigid conditions that we may be projecting onto our relationships, and so the magnifying glass is on our relationships, the relationship first and foremost with ourselves, and then the relationship with others, and how we view ourselves, and whatever wound we have in our I am will bleed out and project onto our relationships. So there's a balancing occurring, bringing our I am into balance, so that we can find harmony in our lives, and our relationships are relationship with the people we love, relationship with friends, with colleagues, with acquaintances, with our finances, with our pets, our animals. It's relationship that is being highlighted during this equinox. And so as we are moving through this time, and we are really listening what's going on within us, we're being aware of how other people may be making us feel. And this is beautiful when it's a loving relationship, but it's also as important when it's in a difficult relationship. And these difficult relationships are where the medicine is. Because as we dissolve our wound of our I am, which these wounds have come from ancestral line, from our past lives, and as we start to heal those wounds of our I am, we then start to bring the relationships around us that are in alignment, that are in harmony with us. So the moon is growing, it's waxing, which is holding this energy and bringing that beautiful support and activating our intuition. We're being asked to come from out of our heads, because we can create enemies in our head. So if a relationship is difficult, we can create an enemy within that relationship that creates conflict and really blocks us from our higher consciousness. But this is coming to an end, which you can see those pins are being taken out of her head, those thoughts that pricked and caused headaches, that caused brain fog, or however those thoughts affected us. Once we stop having them and we come into knowing that this is the Three of Pentacles, we're all here weaving this tapestry of our lives. We're all doing it differently. We all have a different outlook. We all have been through different experiences in our lives. But we're all here creating a new earth together. And as we let go of the disharmony and we come out of our heads and come into our hearts, we will dissolve all conflicts. We will dissolve the enemies. They will dissolve in our hearts. And we can see here the Three of Pentacles is a beautiful creation, a flower that's growing, and we're in this time of harvest. This equinox, this autumn equinox, is a time of harvest. So we're harvesting the fruits of our labours. The apples on the trees are ripe now for picking. All the fruits are ripe for picking now. And as we pick those fruits and we taste them and actually taste them and tune into the intelligence of the fruit, of the seed that's in the fruit, because that seed will create and grow into a tree that will bear fruit, that becomes ripe in our harvest for us to pick. And it's the same with those fruits, those seeds that we have planted are now ripe for harvesting. So this is a time of holding on to the fruit and letting go of the chaff, of storing what is empowering us and what is right for us, what's nutritious for us, and disregarding everything else. And that is what we're taking within our bodies, whether it is what we're listening to, what we're eating, how we're thinking. And so things now holding on to our beautiful fruitful harvest. And then we have the Page of Cups, and this is connection to the higher realms, and a portal is open. And there is mysticism coming through this portal. It's the elementals, the magical beings that are coming through. We've reached a state of consciousness that we are connecting now. And these portals, these energies are activating within us. And this is a very magical time where we are moving now into winter. We are going to, from now, the next change will be the winter solstice. So we're starting to recede. Nature, summer is going to sleep, and this is time where we go within and we connect with that mysticism within. This is when we start to feel spirit around us, where we are, our intuition starts to become extra clear. the page of cups is love, love coming in, and we've got the divine masculine and the divine feminine. Libra is ruled by Venus. Aries is ruled by Mars. So this is the divine masculine and the divine feminine finding their beautiful balance. And this is a new energy. So we're starting to really become aware of when we're out of balance, bringing that balance back in so that we can feel that divine love, that we can feel romance. And this is the start of new love. And you can see there she's looking in to the eyes of that fish, connecting to the fish, to the wisdom and the prosperity that's coming from there. They always symbolize wisdom and prosperity. So she's focusing on that. Her eyes are nowhere else. She's focusing and looking deep within the eyes of the divine, of the consciousness that's around us. Looking in and focusing on the visions of prosperity, of abundance. And as we clear our emotions, all our senses become clear. And then we have the King of Wands, and this is the entrepreneur. He is beating his own drum. He is going with the rhythm of his own song, his own verse. We're all in this universe. We all have a different harmonic, and as we connect to that harmonic that is in harmony within us, we then start to walk and beat our own drum, create our own magic in beautiful alignment and connection with the celestial harmonics that is coming through. So this is a card of the entrepreneur, of really taking ownership of who we are, very compassionate but very clear and focused, and sticks to it, beating his own drum, creating his own magic, his own reality. And then we have the Four of Wands, and this is beautiful balance. We're moving through this 1-1. You can see there the trees are making the 11-11. The Four of Pentacles asks us, what do we want to take through this gateway? And to let go of anything that we're holding on to that's no longer serving us. We have we're at the 23rd today, the 23rd of the 9th, 2023, so both end in 23. So there's a mirror. So this is a mirror day, a reflection, asking us to look at. This is a card of celebration, of happiness, of joy. To look at anything that may be mirroring back at us, there is an hour of this. Because it's a dense energy, it's an heavy energy, to really make sure that we are celebrating ourselves, that we are celebrating life, we are celebrating our loved ones in spirit. We have gone through these immense times of cleansing, of going through grief, of loss, of transformation, these birthing pains, that in those pains we found sacredness there, we found immense wisdom there, and are still. This is a time of celebration, of rising up and allowing love to dissolve anything that is not in alignment with our divine self. So this is a wonderful time of going within and connecting with our inner light and allowing that inner light, that passion within us, flames always burn upwards. And this is the passion within us, it ignites and rises within us. So as we're moving through this time of the equinox, what are we taking into our next season? Reaping and taking the fruits of our labours, the wisdom that we've attained over this time, celebrating everything that we've gone through. This is a beautiful card and one of my most favourite cards, and it's confirmation that everything's going to be okay, to let go of the fear, to let go of the worries and concerns, because whatever we're focusing on at this moment, this light is coming through, helping us to create this. And whatever we're focusing on and whatever we truly believe, we are emanating into this light, to this plasma in front of us, and creating a reality there. So the fifth dimension is coming through our heart. We're not stepping into it. We're not levitating anywhere. It's coming through our hearts, and we start to emanate the energy and it manifests all around us. So coming out of these, this is challenges, the end of these challenges. We've got these beautiful energies activating, our I Am presence activating and bringing the medicine to us through disharmony in our lives, and being able to see it now, being able to bring ourselves into alignment through doing our rituals. We have Neptune activating during this eclipse also. Sorry, equinox also. If I've said eclipse, I mean equinox. We have had the Neptune is in retrograde in Pisces, which is completion. It's the end sign, it's the last sign of the zodiac. So it's retrograde in there in Pisces, and this is what old cycles are we closing? What illusions are we shifting now? With Neptune being in retrograde, it can create illusion, disillusion. So ask us to come out of our head and into our hearts and listen to our intuition. Allow our intuition to guide us. If it feels right, take a step there. If it doesn't, then wait and pause. And all the planets that are in retrograde are asking us to do that. Pluto's still retrograding, asking us to dig deep into what old paradigms need dissolving, what needs transforming within us, what needs alchemizing within us to bring in the harmony. And I'm coming into beautiful harmony with our higher self. So wonderful energy today. beautiful energy, helping us to come into that alignment. So I'm asking for a message from the gods, goddesses and angels, and as always, take what resonates and just put the rest to one side and just feel the medicine of this equinox bringing us into this beautiful time of harmony, of alignment, of healing. We have the angel of emergence, and this card also wants to come up, the goddess of sacred power. So the angel of emergence is time for the real us, the authentic us, to emerge. And Libra, the sun is in Libra today, and Libra is justice in the tarot. It's the card of justice, and it's the justice card is number 11. So it's again, it's that gateway. It's right in the centre, balancing in between, bringing that balance in, that centeredness in, creating that beautiful time of emergence, coming to the authenticity of who we truly are. And then the goddess of sacred power. And this is, we're being encouraged to tap into that sacredness within us. We hold immense wisdom within us. We go into our head, we go outside of ourselves to find this knowledge when it's residing in the very core of us, and we're all receiving it now. We're receiving the light codes, we're receiving those activations. They're within us to listen, to feel our way through this time, and know that our intuition will guide us. Our head will take us round and round in circles. Our heart will guide us. And also Libra, we're in this time of Libra, and it is around justice, bringing that harmony into our lives. And Mahat is the goddess who holds the scales of justice, the cosmic goddess. And as we pass anything that weighs heavier than a feather on these scales, it shows that we are holding something in our hearts, and we will come back and revisit and relearn and come back to heal that karma. So going into this sacredness, feeling the divine within us. And as we feel the divine within us, see the divine in every single person, every single animal, every flower, everything in nature, connecting to the divinity of every living being. And this is the sacred power. Everything holds sacred power. So I'm asking now for a message from Anastas Pack, the sacred light, to bring through some guidance, please, as we go through this time of the equinox and the activations of the I Am presence within. We have two here. Archangel Michael, stepping forward, letting us know that we're protected. And ascension flame. Feel that ascension flame. We are protected. We're being guided. The truth will always be shown when we step out and allow things to unravel in their own divine time. And as we step out, step in, and allow the ascension flame to start to build within us, coming through every cell within our body, allowing our body to merge into the ascension flame. Feel it. This is what's happening in this equinox, the powerful activations of the ascension flame that we hold within us, that I keep feeling through this reading, is bursting and building and building, and it's building with passion, it's building with life force energy to actually walk our sacred path in love and in harmony, connecting with the cosmos that's guiding us, the planets are all guiding us. We have Pluto, Capricorn in Pluto. So, sorry, Pluto in Capricorn, retrograding in Capricorn. So it's helping us to break down the old, to help us to break down the old ways of seeing things and doing things, to be able to connect with our sacredness within. Pisces, Neptune and Saturn. So Saturn retrograding in Pisces, helping us to dissolve old paradigms that disconnect us to our sacredness, to our divinity, to our spiritual essence. So there's lots of energy happening during this equinox, bringing us into this beautiful time of equilibrium to connect with our spiritual band, with our spiritual essence, to quieten and enlighten our mental band, calm our emotions, which in turn will bring our physical body in balance holistically, will bring well-being holistically. So the planets, the star systems, everything in the cosmos is guiding us and helping us, and each planet is helping us to go within, into a certain part of our life, into a certain part of our body, and to go within. And Jupiter retrograding in Taurus, helping us to look within at anything that where we are blocking ourselves, where we're going into contraction, because Jupiter expands. So it's opening those channels that are blocked within us, expanding them so that we can take in all this beautiful light, this proton light, these activations that are coming in, activating our DNA that holds divine wisdom, that holds ancient wisdom, all the way from Lemuria, all the way from Atlantis. We're being activated, that memory is being activated, that sacred knowledge is being activated as we come into this alignment today, ready to then move into the dark side, into the darker nights, the longer nights, the changing in our climate. We'll all wear different clothes, our animals will have their winter coats that they're starting now to come through. We'll be eating different foods. Everything changes during this time to accommodate the change of season, to really just flow with it, to rest when we need to not push through and exhaust ourselves, to just rest and to be gentle with ourselves as we take the journey now within, again, into that world, inner environment. So I'm sending so much love. Have a wonderful equinox weekend, and may you be blessed with fruitful, bountiful life, and may everything, may all your wonderful intentions grow and build and create a reality that is our own heaven on earth for each and every one of us, holding the space for each and every one of us to be able to blossom. I'm sending so much love. Thank you so much for listening, and God bless. Thank you.